This was my first kit. And then I thought, I want to get some better shots. So I sold my car and I was like, yeah, this'll do it. Then I gave up my lease, sold everything I owned, and oh, worth every cent. What's happening? Welcome. Now, I get asked this question almost every single day, and that is, I'm looking to get into underwater photography. What camera do I buy? And if you're asking this, you're not alone. Clearly, there is a lot of choice, and it's very confusing. And with anything underwater, there is a significant amount of cost involved. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk you through from the entry level all the way to the full frame professional DSLRs, give you a range of cameras in each level, and talk about the pros and cons, and hopefully this will help you decide what camera you need. Now, as I mentioned, this here was my first kit. It's a GoPro Hero 3 Plus. And before you fast forward, I'm gonna show you some footage filmed on this that will blow you away. Was that from a GoPro? They're not half bad. Now, the reason that footage looks so good is because I filmed it on this in GoPro's Pro Shoot mode, and I spent a lot of time editing that. If you don't have the time to sit down and edit some footage properly and spend a lot of time learning the software and learning how to do that, I wouldn't recommend a GoPro. But if you are willing to sit down and spend the time editing and filming in Pro Shoot and learning how to edit on things like Adobe Premiere Pro, After Effects, or Final Cut, I definitely recommend the GoPro for video, as long as they have ProTune and as long as you understand the software. Secondly, if you do buy a GoPro, mind the sticky tape, make sure to buy yourself a handle. Now, this will help cut all that shaky footage, it will help keep your camera level, and it will definitely help you with the composition of your shot. It goes without saying that these are made for video. If you're interested in still photography, one last tip on GoPros: a new one of these costs about $1,000. Who has the money for that? Buy a secondhand one. Moving up the range, we have the compact cameras. Now, the biggest difference between a GoPro and a compact camera is the ability of manual controls. You can manually dial in your exposure and your white balance, which is a massive plus. On top of that, you can take photos. Now, the photos these produce are actually extremely good. You'll be blown away by the quality of some of the shots people get on small cameras like this. This right here is a Canon G16, and it's towards the top end of still photography for compact cameras. The video size is not great, it doesn't let you control the manual exposure, but for stills, the G16 produces some stunning results. One other really neat thing I love about this: wet lenses. The biggest downside to shooting on a compact is the fact that you have a fixed lens, but on some of the more expensive housings, they just slot right on the front and you are good to go. Now, some of the cameras that you guys should consider are obviously the Canon G16 if you're interested in still photography. If you're interested in a mixture of still and video, something like the Sony RX100s, start at about the Mark IV and work your way up to the Mark VI. The Mark VI is super expensive, but anything from about Mark IV up. A more budget option is the Olympus TG4 or 5. Now, these come in much cheaper than most other compacts, but they are more limited in terms of their manual controls. So if you're looking for something cheap, the TG4 or 5 produces great still images, but you're not really able to access that full manual mode that you will probably want. This right here, this is my rig. And if you've seen any of my other photo or video content, 99% of it was shot using this here. Now, this is a mirrorless Panasonic Micro Four Thirds camera. Now, if that doesn't mean anything to you, don't panic. It basically gives you all the functions of a full frame DSLR on a smaller sensor. And that just limits the amount you can punch your ISO. Now, the quality is obviously not as good as a full frame camera, but it is a professional rig. I've been shooting content for magazines, for clients, all on this camera here. Now, the main reason you might consider upgrading to a mirrorless camera above a compact camera is better image quality and much better video quality. And most importantly, they have interchangeable lenses. Now, this is a massive plus. Some other options to consider are the Olympus OMD EM5, which is the direct competitor to this camera here. It's a little bit newer, has better video, but the stills are still exceptional. If you're interested in video only, the Panasonic GH4 and 5 are fantastic choices, but their still quality does lack quite a lot. The Sony A6500 and A6300 are also great choices. Oh, and finally, oh my God, this thing is so heavy, and Check out all the buttons on the back of that. Oh my god, it's absurd. It's just covered in buttons. Obviously, the learning curve on one of these is exceptionally high. You cannot just pick one of these up and use it, but the quality you get out of it is far superior to anything else in terms of photo and video. But these come at a significant price, and to house one of these and make them waterproof, honestly, double your costs. And if you are watching this video, you probably don't need one of these cameras. These are top of the end, professional level cameras. And if you need one, you probably know about it. But if you are interested in buying a full frame camera, the D500 is a great choice. The Nikon D850 and D750 are also fantastic choices. The Sony A7 III and A7 R2 are also fantastic choices, all of which both great for photo and video. Now I know what you're gonna say, but in my opinion, Canon has lagged so far behind their competitors that I would honestly stick to both Nikon and Sony right now. Now, I hope you liked this video and you learned something. If you do want to learn more about underwater photography, please hit that like and subscribe button. Check out my video from last week. And if there's something you do want to learn, chuck it in the comments below. Other than that, I'll see you next time.